Now we are going to see about Geoffrey Chaucer. He was a father of English poetry, father of English fiction, the father of English literature, and the father of the English language. And then about his early life, he born on 1340. And he was a son of the prosperous wine merchant, belongs to a middle class. In mid-teens, he was placed in the service of the Countess of Ulster. So, he could obtain more education and be schooled in court and society life. He began his writing in around 20s, and he is the dominant figure in literary during 14th century. His experience was a page in the royal household, soldier and diplomat, member of the parliament. Writing was only a part-time occupation for him. He died around October 25, 1400. He was buried at Poets' Corner at Westminster Abbey. He translated literary works in all three languages. He married a lady in waiting to the queen. In 1359, he was captured by the French at the Siege of Reims during the Hundred Years' War. While serving in English army, he was ransomed by a King Edward III, a year later, showing he was a court favorite. A Chaucer joined the royal household and became a trusted messenger and a minor diplomat. Chaucer was frequently sent to the continent on secret business for the king. Some of these trips were to Italy, where he became acquainted with the works of the greatest Italian authors of the early Renaissance period, Boccaccio, Dante, Petrarch. He was also a controller of a customs on wools, skins and hides for the port of London. Here he met many types of businessmen, sailors, travelers, city folk and common laborers, and then a clerk of the king's worker, while in charge of construction and repairs affecting the royal residences. He met many guildsmen as well as a court officials. He was also a deputy forester of the king's forest. Away from the city, he met peasants, foresters, a local clergy and other country folk, and then a representative of the Shire of Kent in Parliament. He met the rich, the influential and the upper middle class, as well as the higher ranking church officials. He wrote the tales around 1385 AD, planned many more tales, but did not complete the proposed 120 tales before his death. He also wrote about all classes in the Canterbury Tales to give us a glimpse of English society at the time. He went against the tradition when he wrote in a Middle English rather than French, so it makes everyone to consider him as a father of the English language, and he chose to write in the language of people. Thank you.